Hello student, in last lecture we have seen the some problems on permutation with objects which are not all distinct, and we have seen some conditions given in those problems, and related to those problems we have used the formulae and find out the number of ways or permutations, how to find it. Now let us see the third type of the problem. That is, some letters or consonant or vowels are always together or not together. Now see the first example of this type. There are three families. First consists of 5 members, second consists of 4 members, and third consists of 3 members. In how many ways can they take seats in a row in a theater so that members of the same family are together? Now here 3 families are given. The conditions are that all these 3 families should be together. That means members of the family should be together. Now how many seats we have? So count the seats. That is first family of 5 members. So 5. Plus second family with 4 members, so plus 4, and third family with 3 members, so plus 3. So total number of seats is equal to 5 plus 4 plus 3. That means totally we have 12 seats to be arranged. Now 3 families can be sit together in 3 places. Now why 3 places? Because we are going to bunch it accordingly, 5 plus 4 plus 3. That's why this 5 is taken as a one bunch, this 4 is taken as one bunch, 3 is taken as a one bunch. So that's why we have taken as a 3 together, that's why 3 families together, that's why 3 places and 3 families. So 3 families taken all at a time, so that is 3p3. So by formula it is 3 factorial upon 3 minus 3, 0 factorial, or you can use the formula, that is npn is equal to n factorial, so that is equal to 3 factorial. Here we have given the 12 seats, 1, 2, 3 up to 12. Now the first family consists of 5 members. So they can sit within themselves. That means once we allot 5 seats to 5 members, then they can interchange within themselves and they can arrange it or they can sit it in 5p5, that is equal to 5 factorial ways. Second family of 4 members can sit within themselves in 4p4, that is equal to 4 factorial ways. Third family of 3 members can sit within themselves in 3p3, that is 3 factorial ways. And therefore by multiplication principle. By multiplication principle, because we want to allot the 3 families and 5 members family and 4 member family and 3 member family. So that's why by multiplication principle, total number of ways 3 family can sit together in this 3 factorial into 5 factorial into 4 factorial into this 3 factorial, and the answer is 6 into this 120 into 24 into 6, that is equal to this 103680. So that is the total number of ways we can do the arrangement of this family with members together. Now let us see the next example. In how many ways can 4 girls, 4 boys and 2 professors be seated for photograph so that professors occupy the central seats and all the girls together? Now first of all find out the total number of seats. So 4 girls plus 4 boys plus 2 professors. So 4 plus 4, 8 plus these 2, 10. So these are the 10 seats that we want to arrange. Now I have given here 1, 2, 3 up to 10. Now allot the seats according to the condition. Now again we should concentrate which condition should be first fulfilled. Now the first condition is given that we want to check it the conditions that girls to be together, boys to be together and professors in the central position. These are the three conditions. Now first of all, I will give the preference to the professor seat. So professors want to be central position. So for 10 divided by 2, that is 5. So 5th and 6th, these are the two central position. So I have allotted this seat number 5 and 6 to the professor. Now these are the two seats and two professor. So they can sit within themselves, that is either AB or BA, like that, in two ways. So two professors can occupy two central positions in 2P2, that is 2 factorial, and 2 factorial is nothing but 2. So it is equal to 2 ways. Now the second condition is that the girls should be together. Now there are 4 girls. So girls want to sit together. So either they can take the position to the left of the professor. And that's why I have given here the girls position. That means either girl can take the position 1, 2, 3 up to 4. That is one possibility. Or girl can take the position to the right of the professor, that is position number, seat number 7, 8, 9 and 10. So these are the 4 seats that girl can take. So girls has 2 options, either to the left of the professor or to the right of the professors. So 2 positions or 2 ways, that is girls can occupy 2 positions, either to the left or to the right of the professors in 2 ways, and within themselves they can change, because there are 4 positions to the girls, so they can occupy the seats in 4P4 ways. So it is 4P4. So total number of ways that girls can occupy the seats is this 2, either this left or right, that's why it is 2 into this 4P4 ways. Now once girls takes, if this this is the position that to the left of the professor, then obviously the position to the right will be remaining for boys. And if the girls takes the position to the right, then in that case boys will take the position to the left of the professor. Now there are 4 positions remain for the boys and there are 4 boys. So 4 seats can occupy by 4 boys within themselves is 4P4 ways. And now we have to allot the seats to the girls and professors and to the boys. So since and is there, therefore by multiplication principle, total number of permutations or sitting arrangement is nothing but this 2 for professors into 2 into 4P4 into this 4P4. So 4P4 is 4 factorial. So 2 into 2 into 4 factorial into 4 factorial, and the answer is 4 into 24 into 24, that is 2304. So these are the total number of ways we can do the arrangement that professors at the central position and the girls together, boys together. Now let us see the next example. 6 gentlemen and 5 ladies are to be seated for a photograph in a row such that no 2 ladies are together and no 2 men sit together. Find the number of ways in which this can be done. Now total number of seats, 6 gentlemen plus 5 ladies, that is 6 plus 5, that is equal to 11. Now I will denote male by M and female by F. So totally 6 arrangements, 11 arrangements are there. So I have written here 1 to 11. Now the condition is that no 2 ladies together and no 2 gentlemen together. That means alternative ladies and gents, that is possible. Now if I am going to start the first seat with male, then no 2 male together, that means male will take the position after this first position, that is third position, then fifth position, then seventh, then ninth, and then 11th. Then in the middle one, right? F, that is allot for female, so female even place, that is 2, then 4, then 5, 6, then 8, and then 10. Now in this arrangement, there is no males together, no females are together, so both conditions are satisfied. So this arrangement is possible. So male can occupy the odd places, that is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and 11. So these are the 6 places and 6 male. So they can change within themselves and they can sit in 6P6 base. Now remaining these 5 places in the even position. So female can occupy even places, that is 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. So 5 females in 5 ways, they can, that means within themselves, can sit in 5P5 ways. And therefore by multiplication principle, total number of permutations is equal to 6P6 into 5P5, that is 6 factorial into 5 factorial. So 6 factorial is 720 into 5 factorial is 120. So the total product is 86,400. Now you may have the doubt that why we should start immediately with male. Is there any possibility that we should start with female? So let us check it. Here, if we are going to start with the first position with female, then second position obviously, that means no two ladies together. So after first position, third position will be for female. Then fifth, then seventh, then ninth. Now there are 5 females. So the odd places, that is 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9, that will be for female. Now remaining 6 male, so they will get the even position, that is 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. Now these are the 5 males, but the 6th male will come at the odd place, that is here 11th. And now in this case, these 2 males are coming together. But our condition that no 2 male together and no female together. Out of that, no female together, that condition is fulfilled. But no males together, that is not fulfilled here. And that's why this arrangement is not possible. And that's why we have the only one possibility, is that starting with male, that is possible. Got it, all of you? Now let us see the next example. Find the number of 4 letter words can be formed from the letters of the word computer. How many of them begin with T and end in a vowel? And second condition, begin and end by a consonant. Now first one is, that is begin with T and end in a vowel. Now total number of letters in the word computer, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So total number of letters N, that is equal to 8. Now which are the vowels that comes in the word computer? So that is nothing but O, E and U. And which are the consonant that comes in the word computer? That is C, M, P, T and R. Now we want to form a 4 letter word. So that's why I have given here 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the 4 letters that we want to place. 4 letters to form the word. Now here begin with T, and that's why in the first position I have written here T. End in a vowel. So vowels are O, E and U, and that's why here in the fourth position, that is end position, that I have written here O, U and E. These are the 3 vowels. So out of that, only one will be placed here. So the first letter begins with T, that can be placed in only one way. There is no any option, so that is only one way. But this fourth letter that can be filled with 3 vowels, So three letters and taken one at a time. So that can be 3P1, that is equal to 3 factorial upon 3 minus 2, 3 minus 1, that is 2 factorial. So that is equal to 3 base. Now remaining are the letter number, that is 2 and 3. So remaining two letters, that means in second and third position, can be filled by. Now total number of letters are 8. And one is filled in the first position, one is filled in the last position. So 8 minus 2, that is 6. So remaining two letters that can be filled by remaining 6 letters in how many ways? 6P2, that means 2 at a time. And therefore, by multiplication principle, total number of ways 4 letter words can be formed is 1 into this 3 into this 6P2. So that is equal to 3. 6P2 is nothing but 6 factorial upon 6 minus 2, that is 4 factorial. So up to 4 factorial it will get cancelled. So it is 5 into 6. So it is 3 into 5 into 6. So 3 5s are 15 into 6, that is equal to 90 ways that we can do the arrangement of these letters. So that is the way how we can utilize this condition and allot the seats. Now let us see the second condition, that begin and end in a consonant. Now the positions are same, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Total number of letters, that is equal to n, that is equal to 8. Now the vowels are O, E and U and the consonant are C, M, P, T and R. Now we want begin, that means first position and the fourth position with consonant. Totally how many consonants are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So out of these 5 consonant, 2 positions we want to fill up. So the letter begins and ends with consonant. So first and fourth places are filled with 5 consonant in 5P2 ways. Remaining are the middle 2, that is second and third position. So middle 2 places can be filled with remaining. Out of 8, 2 will be given to first and fourth. So remaining are 6. So how many form remaining 6 letters in 6P2 ways, and therefore by multiplication principle total number of ways 4 letter word can be formed is this 5P2 into 6P2 ways. So 5P2 is nothing but 5 factorial upon 5 minus 2, that is 3 factorial. 6P2 means 6 factorial upon 6 minus 2, that is 4 factorial. Up to 3 factorial, 5 factorial means product of 1 to 5. 3 factorial means product of 1 to 3. So up to 1 to 3 it will get cancelled. So after 3 remaining is 4 and 5. So it is 4 into 5. Here up to 6 factorial. So up to 4 factorial it will get cancelled. So remaining is 5 into 6. So take the product. 5, 6 are 30. 30 into 4, 5 are 20. So it is 600 ways that we can form the letter with begin with and end with the consonant. Now let us see the next example. The 9 papers are to be set at an examination, 2 of which are on statistic. In how many ways can the examination program be arranged so that 2 statistic papers are always together and neighbor together. Now all these examples above we have seen, that is starting with or end with, or first example that is always together. Here is one condition, that is neighbor together. That is difference here in this example. Now if such cases are there, then how to solve it? Now there are 9 papers that we want to set for the examination. So 9 papers can be arranged in 9p9, that is equal to 9 factorial. So always find out the total number of ways how we can do the arrangement, though whether it is asked or not asked. So that is 9 factorial ways. Now the first condition is always together. Now there are 2 statistic papers and we want they to be together. So the statistic papers are always together. So that can be treated as a single paper. That means if we are going to keep statistic paper in one envelope, then that will be enough. That is 2 papers will be within that one envelope. Like that we will treat it as a single paper or single envelope. Like that it is a single paper. So remaining 8 different papers will be arranged in 8p8 ways. But since these are the 2 statistic paper, they can interchange within themselves. So that is a 2. And this is 8p8. So this is 8p8. So 8p8 is 8 factorial. So 2 into this 40,320. So that is equal to 80,640. These are the number of ways that the 2 statistic papers are always together. Now remaining is the neighbor together. For neighbor together, total number of arrangements when they are neighbor together equal to total number of arrangements minus the number of arrangements when they are together. So always first of all that is find out their total number of arrangements is 9 factorial. So it is 9 factorial minus they are always together. So that is 2 into 8p8, that is 2 into 8 factorial. So here we are having 9 factorial minus 2 into 8 factorial, and this is the answer, that is 2,82,240. That will be the answer. So calculation part you can do, find out the 8 factorial, find out the 9 factorial and take the product and find out, check the answer whether it is coming to be. So that is the condition for. So we have seen all the types of the examples, that is 3 types of the categories we have done, and we have solved all the examples related to these permutations. That means arrangement of the objects, whether they are distinct or whether they are similar, always together, never together, with repetition and without repetition. So in the next lecture, we will see about the combination. So thank you.